Welcome, everyone, and today we're here to have a discussion on sustainability, cow behavior, and precision farming. Today, our special guest for our speaker series is Dr. Joao Costa. He is a professor and researcher at the University of Kentucky and is also published in the Journal of Dairy Science. Welcome, Joao, and thank you for talking with us today. We appreciate it.
No, thank you. Thank you both for having me here today.
Absolutely. So, can you talk about the work that you do as a professor in dairy science?
Yeah, definitely. So, well, we, beyond teaching the students and be at the university and having extension with the producers, I think we've been creating a laboratory looking at how we integrate technology, animal behavior, and on-farm management, on-farm decision into the future of the dairy industry. We have been researching new techniques, new technology, new use, and especially that relationship between machine, animal, and human in our farms. And we've been doing that for, I don't know, the last few years, and more expanding that research into the future and the technology that are coming up.
Yeah, very interesting.
Yeah, and with that, you know, up and coming technology, you know, such as our product, with someone with your education and experience, what are your thoughts on our technology and the future of the dairy industry as a whole?
Well, so I think it's not just our industry, right? If we talk about how technology is being integrated on our daily lives, I think it's no difference when we talk about agriculture. Sometimes we even, I think most of us in the industry have seen the same slide talking about how the 20, 25 different industries that we have right now in the US economy, agriculture is one that is lacking behind on some of that integration with technology, with digitalization in general. And I think you guys or other technologies that are coming up are coming to fulfill that gap, right? I think options need to be created. No option is going to fit everybody. And I think we need to understand where each option will do and will fit for our produce, for our industry, even for our animals. Sometimes we forget that a big chunk, a big part of our industry is made of animals of other species, like cattle, pigs, whatever industry we are talking about. So when I heard about your guys' technology, all the technology that actually do the job or is come to make an automation of management that generally has been done by hand, I think there is a very good place for it. I think one thing that I believe in, we have been researching and doing more and more, is that technology are not going to be just collecting data, but also respond to management and knowledge that we already have. So instead of tell us like, this is what is happening in the farm right now, you know, like go there and do something about it automatically. And not just talking about you guys, but in general, I think that is the path that we are going to be walking in the future. And we, you know, like we are doing the first step of a marathon probably. So technology, you know, I always use the example of our phones. It's great that our phones track steps, but it would be better if it did something about it, right? Like if it is, send me a message to tell, or even vibrate as a Fitbit to tell me to walk, is things like that. And I think that that's the future, in my opinion, at least.
Yeah, no, thank you for sharing your thoughts on that. I mean, it's going to be more and more challenging to feed the planet as time goes on. And I mean, ag tech is only going to be growing as the years come, especially within dairy. So thanks for sharing your thoughts on that.
Yeah, I would agree. And, you know, none of us here, you know it's a secret that, you know, the dairy industry as a whole can be like highly scrutinized by the general public. And since, you know, you have experience in analyzing kind of cow behavior, can you talk a little bit more about the roles at play between human behavior and cows kind of versus how cows behavior and stress levels are with technology, those two like dichotomies?
Well, I will first start a little bit out of that, the main question you ask, and say that I'm a deep believer that technology can be used to not just improve animal welfare, but especially to monitor animal welfare. I would say that, you know, like every, well, obviously if we want, we can do much better, but in general, animal welfare levels on dairy farms are very good, but we need to make sure that we identify the ones that are not or are having trouble in general, not because people want or intentionally or non-intentionally. I think technology plays a big role on that. Well, I just, you know, I have a big project just funded to do that, to make sure that we create streams of data that would alert us to farms and the rare event where animals would be challenging their own animal welfare level. And I think that that's fundamental. The second part is that the technology, when it comes to the management, we are sure, well, obviously it's independent of each technology, so something that we need to talk specifically, but broadly, most of the behaviors done by a technology, or most of the management done by a technology, is actually have a positive effect on behavior of animals, especially prey animals like cattle. They like constancy, they like routine, they know, they like to know what is going to happen to them. So generally, a piece of machinery will repetitively do the same thing every day, every time. Without change, animals get to expect that, they know what is going to happen. You know, like humans can be affected by many things, including their personal life before walking on that farm, or their knowledge, their training, many other factors. And that can create, you know, we have 30, 40 years of research on that problem, right? How the human-animal interaction is not constant, is can be difficult sometimes. So I think the robots is a classic anecdote to that. When robots came, and I'm aging myself again and saying that, like when they were coming out, I was one of the ones that was like, oh, our cows will become very wary. They will not see people every day walking them twice per day to the milking parlor. You know, they will become wild, they'll become beef cows almost. And that belief was very common in the industry. And now 20, 15 years later, we know that it's actually the opposite. Cows perceive pretty negatively that you go there and take them all out of their pen and throw in a little place. And the robot gave us the ability, the human, to be a person that just walks by and do good things to them. And actually robot cows are, or cows that are milked by a robot, are actually more calm in general, right? It varies farm by farm, region by region, breed by breed. But generally speaking, cows that are in automated milking systems are cows that are more approachable and more friendly, let's say, with humans. So I think that that is an example where the piece of machine, the technology, the precision way of farming actually improve animal welfare, and that relationship of human, animal, and farming.
Very interesting. Yeah, I think you said a couple great things about, you know, really just improving relations between the consumer market and the food supply chain, and something that we're trying to do to kind of allude back to the technology that you're speaking of that could trace these animals that are potentially challenged. We're really trying to focus on the traceability aspect of these pharmaceuticals going into these animals. So, you know, that way, if something came up, whatever that is, we could always refer back to the data management system and see right there that she got her respective shot on that respective day. So us two, we're definitely thinking moving forward, how can we help the dairy industry, but at the same time provide value for the customer? The customer wants to trust us, right? So thank you for sharing that.
Well, just to add to that, it's funny because obviously I'm very interested on the cow side and the farm management, but more and more we have been approached, and I've been part of that exact discussion that you're mentioning, that at this point in time, when we have a drop of milk in a product, in a dairy product, or even a fluid milk, like You know, we could all walk to Costco, Walmart right now, and we get any bottle of milk out of the shelf. No one would be able to tell us the level of lameness, when that cow's got any shots, if which feed was fed, which almost not which farm comes from, the region or the milk line, maybe the milk route, maybe. And we are going to that place, right? Like it's very different. My car, if I have any problem, if one screw in the middle of the radiator comes loose 100,000 miles in, Ford is able to go back and trace it, you know, where the iron came from, which source, which lot.
Right.
And I think that will be one of the major, and there is a lot of money interest from the process, from the industry in general, from society, for us to be able to say and do that. You mentioned pharmaceutical. We can discuss if that is animal welfare or not, but definitely there are many other things, right? Like, was the shot applied well? Did that anything happen, right? What was lameness on that farm when X and Y? And I think blockchain, data management, technology in general will allow us to do so. When we don't depend on notebooks anymore and we have cloud system that collect, transmit, and store data and store it forever.
Absolutely.
Yeah, actually, it's a very good point. I never thought on traceability of shots, and that is actually a very, very interesting point.
Appreciate it. Appreciate that a lot.
And I guess just, you know, touching on precision farming and agriculture as a whole, what are those next steps, or what does like the future of the dairy look like in your eyes?
Well, that is what I think, right? If I knew for certain, I would be investing in the stock market and make millions. But I really think that there are three major challenges that we face in the dairy and, well, animal protein agriculture in general. That is not just the lack of labor, but the availability of labor to do some of the tasks that we have. So technology is coming to fulfill some of these needs. If it is, you know, I think a classic example was the need of someone sit and watch animals 20 minutes, 3-4 times a day to look at hits or look at when cows were in estrus, and we replaced that for a ear tag. And then we found out that we could do more with that ear tag, but you know, that is the type of things that is an obvious example that has happened. And I think that has a long path into the future. You know, replace something that we do by hand or by eyes or with our own effort to something that the technology can do, and then find out that that technology there at the farm can do actually more and change the way we do things. I think the second one is to use the data that we have. I think that is pretty much an explore in our industry. We have many initiatives, including of our own, to create big data bins or storage places that we are going to create predictive algorithms. Many industries or many companies are creating some, but we have even thought on that integrative possibilities that we have of that data, right? Farm, animal, management, output, product. We will need a lot of creativity and especially a lot of willingness to all these people get together, sit in the table and actually discuss the possibilities and make it work. But data is a major one. And I think the third one is that we have a lot of technology that have been adapted to our industry, or even created to do something specifically. But more and more, we are going to have technology that do more than one task at the farm. And, you know, if it is something that comes to, like the robot, I use an example, comes to milk the cows, and then we see that we can collect all this data, feed the animal, and do X, Y, and Z, and even create things that we cannot see at this point. I think that integrative part of the business needs to happen, and I think is the future, right? Like when... at this point in time, we have, who knows, I saw on the slide the other day saying that we have something like 200 companies and startups working with precision technology in the agribusiness in the US. And I think that one of the things that will happen in the future is that, you know, your Google knows data that comes from your Apple cell phone, and both of them are gaining a value doing that. And when we understand that, to start to do this type of things, I think we are going to move forward for more integrative approaches on that part of the industry.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think something I've heard over the years from my co-founder Marinus, who's a dairy farmer himself, is that there's just simply not enough hours in the day to get everything done. And I think really, in our eyes too, it's not necessarily creating automation to replace people. I think at the end of the day, it's to make the dairy farmer's job easier, and so that his farm could still operate better than before, but now he also has more time to spend with his family or tend to other parts of the operation. What were some of your favorite research and extension projects that you've participated in?
Well, so I've been shaping. Actually, I was trained as a, I got engineers very long ago now, aging myself a little bit, but throughout, like scientifically, most of my research has been on the applied behavior, ethology, and especially animal welfare, or how to manage animals in better environments. And I was introduced to technology to actually help my research, like how to collect more data, how to use that data to make better inference, how to create algorithms that would improve the life of animals in general. And more I did that, more I got interest on exactly that we are here to talk about, that is, okay, we collect a lot of data. We make these beautiful algorithms that predict us what is going to happen, but it ended there. And then that was sent as a report or sent as a beautiful graph on someone's computer that generally was a farmer that was too busy and didn't use that data. Or, you know, didn't have the resource at the time to use that data properly. And lately, I would say the last 2-3 years now, we have been, not just me, but a group of scientists being very involved on how to create the, or how to close that cycle, that we collect data, we have a stream of data being generate, create the algorithm, but what could we do automatically to select animals and to perform action on farm? If it is to give an injection, if it is to cool that animal, if it is to give a different feed, if it is to milk differently, that is to be found to, for us to make. And I think that that is the future. Like one, talking about a very interesting one, I think that automated cameras to look at body condition score and select animals that should be bred or not based on the trends that is coming up. It's very interesting, especially with semen to use, which fertility to expect, and do that automatically, that the farmer gets a hit alert plus a list of semen that should be done, is the type of things that I think is interesting and is coming, and could be obviously with injection to give, with feed to feed. But I think that is things that wake me up in the morning motivated to, well, right now come to my basement, but before to go to my office.
Absolutely. No, you're totally right. And that's one thing to have data, but if you don't know what to do with that data or how to make decisions from it, what good is that data really for these farmers? And I think that is a huge disconnect in the industry. So it's cool to see that you're motivated in that regard.
Kind of getting to the end of our discussion, another question, how can we automate on-farm management better? And how can we really incorporate it on modern dairy farms today?
Well, I think that is, again, a $1 million question, but seeing it happening and is happening, we want or not this, you know, like sometimes when we talk about digitalization of technology, what people envision is the automated tractor going through Iowa's cornfield and doing all itself, right? Fertilizing, collecting, storing all this data. And I think that when we talk about animals, this will be a little bit different. We are talking about sentient beings. They think, they act, they are independent on its own. I think, as I mentioned, collect, analyze, predict, and do things on farm is where we needed to be. And I'm not saying that just because you guys actually act on management, but I think that is the future. That is where we are going, not just collect data and send an email, but doing something about it, obvious tracking. But sometimes we need to understand as well that has the other side, right? There's a lot of investment, there is a lot of risk, a big culture of farming, not just in this country, but in the world, that we also will have to change and we have to work with. This is not all bad. It's not that all culture of farming traditionally is terrible. The opposite took us here and make us very successful in feeding 7 point some billion people in the world. But as anything else, right? If we want to raise a child right now, we need to raise a child differently than in the 70s.
Right.
And if we want to raise cattle right now, and we want to raise cattle in 2050, we'll look very different than we did in 1970s. So the challenge that we have are big, but I think we have a lot of smart people. And one thing that I see, and I will talk about you guys as well, is that integration of people that farm with people that come from other sectors, like mechanical engineering, the data science, computing. I think that's what makes creativity happen and insights happen, and make us able to, you know, just make sure that some of those challenges are overcome. Technology will come, not all of them will stay, but the ones that will stay will change the way we farm. That's how I think, and that's how I approach it.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's a, you know, great note to end it on, leave people with those final thoughts. So Joao, thank you so much again for, you know, joining us today and sharing some of your wisdom on the dairy industry and supporting us on our mission to improve the lives of dairy cows and dairy farmers. So thank you again.
No, thank you guys for the space, and please let me know if there is anything else that we can collaborate on. And I hope you guys all success in the world.